Okay, everybody, we're lesson five. Today we're going to go over the Siu Nim Tao. Siu Nim Tao basically means little idea in Wing Chun. This is the first form. This is the form that you really, really, really want to get good at if you want to master the basics of Wing Chun, of how to, at least in our system, the way you do the Siu Nim Tao is very, very important. If you do it in an incorrect way, you're not going to learn concepts, right? And what the most important thing when you're doing the Siu Nim Tao is learning, is practicing concepts. The actual movements of Siu Nim Tao are, they're important, but they're not really, that's not what you're focusing on. You're focusing on what's happening inside the body and making sure that conceptually you're completely consistent all the way through, right? And what does consistent mean? It means that my pendulum, when I get into my position, I'm going to sink down here like that. I'm going to sink down a bit lower when I get into to do the Siu Nim Tao, because I want to practice sinking down and creating. I want to use it as an exercise to help build this sort of sinking strength, right? That I have. My thighs will get quite strong when I do this in a specific way. And that's kind of important when you do this, to get down a bit lower so you can practice standing. Standing is super, super important, right? Learning how to stand, learning how to connect to the ground. And you see this more in Tai Chi. You don't see this so much in Wing Chun. It's a real shame that Wing Chun people don't do it. They get into these very contorted stances and they don't develop good standing and they don't develop any way of sinking inside and sinking down into the ground. Well, that's what we want. We want to create a sinking force down into the ground. And I like to imagine this as someone holding my pendulum like this, and it sinks down, connects into the ground. We're going to go a bit lower. So I'm going to do the Siu Nim Tao in a specific way that I do it. And this helps to cultivate internal power, right? And that means just adhering to the concept. That means I'm constantly focusing on holding this weight inside my hip cavity like that. And imagine it like balancing in between my heels there, keeping my lower back flat, making sure my shoulders are back and my elbows are down in every move I do, making sure the movements are soft and fluid, right? Soft and fluid, right? So they're not tense, then there's no tension when I'm doing it. And I'm constantly thinking of someone who's like got a pump, like they've got a, or like a hose pipe, right? That they're just turning the water on and my body fills up with water when I'm doing it. And there's no tension in my body, but there's intent. There's intent, but no tension. So I'm going to go over this in the Siu Nim Tao, just follow it along and practice it as best you can. Okay. Okay, that is my interpretation of the Siu Nim Tao. You're going to see this vary, again, you're going to see this vary from Wing Chun practitioner to Wing Chun practitioner. This is our method, this is the way that we do it. The pattern of movements that you're doing, I don't care, personally. You do it backwards, that's fine. You take segments out of it, chop it up, whatever you want. But if you want to develop internal power, internal skill, you have to do it with this straight spine, the sinking down into what's called the Danchen in Chinese philosophy, or what we might regard as the pendulum, the bowl of the pendulum here, the shoulder connected and down and the elbow down, and releasing down always and developing this kind of softness and fluidity. This is how you develop internal power. So that one I'm a stickler on, right? Do the Siu Nim Tao, all of this stuff, this, you won't create internal power that way. You'll get good external power, and I'm sure you can make it work, but it's not internal, and there's a big difference. So look at the Siu Nim Tao as like a dictionary. It's just like ABCs, right, of your movements. How to stand, how to balance yourself, how to go through hand movements, different techniques, while maintaining this kind of centeredness. Okay, that's the end of this lesson, and we'll see you for the next one.